Are you thinking about or starting the process of downsizing, or the conversations, or even just the little nudge in the back of your head? You know, it can be a really daunting process, but it doesn't have to be. I'm Denise Swick with RE/MAX Performance, and I'm a certified relocation specialist. There's four important things to consider when you're thinking of downsizing. I'd like to share those with you now. Number one is the cost, and that's probably the most important factor for some people, where cost is included in what is your home actually worth? What can you get out of it in today's market when you're looking to sell? Next is, where are you moving to and what's that cost look like? Sometimes, you know, the cost of where you're going is going to be more than the cost of where you're coming from. And how is that gap going to be bridged? As well as, you'll want to look at, you know, if you're buying a condo, the monthly fees. And don't forget the moving cost and storage cost potentially of what it's going to take between moving from your current home into your next, you know, home, condo, or a, you know, facility. Number two, and most importantly, is thinking about the proximity of where you're going to go. So proximity to your family, proximity to your friends, proximity to your recreation, like how close is where you're looking to go going to be to, you know, your family members and friends? Is it going to be a expensive plane ride, or is it going to be, you know, 20 minutes across town? Like, those are really important things to consider of what's important to you with regards to how far you want to be from your family, your friends, and your recreation. Number three, lifestyle. It's going to be a lifestyle change. Anytime you downsize, it's going to be a different environment. So you have to really think about, how close am I going to be to my healthcare facilities? How close am I to my doctors in my new location? You know, you always have to think about transportation, you know? Maybe driving now is perfect, but, you know, maybe down the road, it's not going to be so easy. I mean, I have problem now at night sometimes having trouble driving. So, you know, you have to really kind of think about, you know, where you're going to be and how close you're going to be. And can you, you know, drive, or was there a bus or something that you can take? And then finally, you know, it's even important to see, how close is the grocery store? You know, do you have to do all your grocery shopping in one day? Or if you're like me, I'm constantly stopping, going back and forth to the grocery store. And how convenient is that going to be? So think about your lifestyle, where it is now, and then where you're going to be later. And that leads me to number four, is how long do you really think that you're going to be in that next location? Is it a downsized temporary move? Is it going to be your forever home, you know? And if it is your forever home, you have to really consider the three items before, which is cost, proximity, and lifestyle, because is it going to provide everything that you need, whether it's 5, 10, or 20 years from now? So hopefully you appreciate these tips. If there's anything else I can do for you, any questions we can ask, I'm Denise Swick with RE/MAX Performance, and you can visit us at DaytonRealEstateOnline.com, or you can call me direct at 937-619-7454. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Take care.